socios. Bienvenidos a la zona VIP. And this is the chalk and talk session. And these subjects have been instigated by Brenda Olsen. So she's asked for us to cover the verb pegar, and also to cover this funny thing that goes on in Spanish where the people say things like que sí, que no, que tengas un buen día, que vengas mañana. A que sí. Pegar, the verb in itself, means to stick. But we have an expression, stick one on him. I'm going to stick one on him. Okay, well, that expression they have in Spanish and they use pegar. Una canción pegadiza. What that is, that's our expression of a catchy tune. When a tune, you get it, you listen to a tune and it sticks in your head all day. I remember being in the factory in Mexico and I was timing somebody. And I was listening to this conversation going on between two girls, and then the girl was saying, que sí, que sí. And the other girl was answering, que no, que no. And it went on for ages. Que sí, que no, que sí, que no. And I was so absolutely confused. What you will see in Spanish is this happening a lot. Sentences beginning with que. So what really would it be when somebody says que no? In my book, it would be something like, te estoy diciendo que no. Yeah? I am telling you that no. Que no quiero ir al cine. So that applies to lots of other things that you'll hear. You'll hear people just starting a sentence off with que decía. So whenever you're confronted with this que starting of a sentence, or a que, or whatever type of que, typically it's obvious what the front end has to be. It used to cause me a lot of confusion, but now it's kind of like, I know now what they're doing. So I just, in my mind, I invent the front end of the sentence. Might be wrong sometimes, but most times you're not.